Okay, thanks, Shirley. This is the third one. It's done. Okay. I'll start with this.
Okay.
So, dear subscribers, as you have heard from our previous video and all this thing, that this is the certificate we are giving after the completion of the course. You will get one for the customer service, the other for the telephone skills. This certificate is your bread and butter. This will make you enhance your life. It will increase your status and your station in wherever you are working. Hi dear subscribers, I am back. I really, really enjoy coming and speaking with you. This is a big effort. Don't think that it's so easy to make these videos and these courses and all. This is all our experience involved in it. It's been saturated with the total lifespan of 67 years thrown into this 10 minutes video segments. Believe me. So the third chapter was on empathy. Again, whatever chapter you bring in regarding customer service, regarding human interaction, is close to my heart. Empathy. It is, I could say, the topmost stage of sympathy, when you can feel something for somebody. Sympathize, somebody has had an operation, somebody has just made an accident by car, or somebody has slipped on the road, is in the hospital, you sympathize with them. Or somebody is in very dire deeds, they don't have enough money to eat, you sympathize with them. Or when you are watching the movies and the TV and the news, you know nowadays, this is now 28 January 2015, we are recording this video. In these times, anytime you open the TV, open any news, any radio, it's all depressing. You will have a heart attack if you, for the whole day, keep yourself being bombarded by this news which comes in. Everything is bad. There are no heroes, nobody's doing a good deed, no country is loving the other country, they're all fighting. I'm not going to go into that. These things I can explain in my lifelong contentment chapters, which we do on that other channel. That's another thing. Here we are, when you can sympathize with somebody, when you see some flood coming to some other distant country, you are not involved, but you do sympathize. You do say so. You feel sorry for those people, those unfortunate people. Now that was sympathy, but now we are relating this to customer service. The same customer in these times, when he walks into your place, whatever business you are in, whether it's a cafeteria, whether it's a restaurant, whether it's a hotel, whether it's a supermarket, whether it's a tourism department, whatever you sell, even schools, not only schools, even lawyers' offices, wherever you are interacting with clients, subscribers, buyers, sellers, and customers and home guests, these are all the sponsors. You have to have an etiquette, the manners, the way you handle them, and what you have to, what is required of you, what is expected of you. The customer service part is that not only do you have to do what is expected of you, you have to go beyond that, so that you are counted as out of the crowd. You are not just one of the competitors. You are somebody special, somebody unique. You give extraordinary service. So part of the chapter today is number three, it's empathy. What has empathy got to do with this customer service is, as I told you, in these times, the bad news everywhere, everything is static and so much knowledge and bad knowledge, and your mind needs peace, they need rest. So you will say, okay, let them go to a movie. How can you be sure that the movie also is not depressing? The movie also is not what you don't want to hear. entertainment, you play games on the mobile, or you go to a games parlor. No, that again is giving you that blood pressure, because you are again either killing somebody in that game or challenging your competitor. Even if it's a bowling alley and all, it's again competition. Customer service is the only profession where there is no competition. Your reward is happy customers. So where is the competition? The challenge is there. Empathy. The same customer nowadays walks into your place. He has been bombarded by all that negative news. The taxi driver may have been rude to him. The airport, he must have missed a flight. And maybe he's forgotten one of his bag in the taxi. Everybody has problems. When they come to you, you are a caregiver, you are a holistic person, you are an angel in human form. Make those people feel welcome. Make them forget their problems. Problems do not go away by forgetting them, but they don't nag you all the time. Keep them on one side. You have to show them the way. Greet them well. Give them the warmth they need. Give your positive vibrations and empathize with them. Empathize means put yourself in their shoes. If you had the same type of thing, maybe they have not even slept the night. Maybe they caught an early flight and the food was not good in that airline, and the taxi driver was rude, and the custom people were little bit too official. Maybe the signature was not matching, maybe the passport date was not very clear, whatever. It was a bad day for that client, that customer, that sponsor, that guest, whoever is seeking your service. To understand, if you have been in that place, you can imagine when these customers walk in, these guests walk in through your door. First of all, thank God that they have thought of your place out of thousands there are. They could have gone to any other place. They have opened the door, they have walked in. Thank God for that, and then welcome them through your heart and tell them you understand what they have gone through. And to understand is the empathy you have to put. Imagine their journey. If you had come through that door with that frustration, with that feeling, would you be in a good mood? You would be angry, you would be biting at everybody. You would think that it's your fault. And that is natural. If you are a professional customer service provider, you will always understand that whoever is the first guy comes in front of an angry customer is supposed to be the culprit. They will throw everything at you. You are the victim. Professional people will not do that. Just like in a psychiatric ward, a doctor is treating that patient and the patient becomes white. They start hitting the doctor. Do they take them to court? Do they file a suit against them? No, this is expected. They know this patient will go wild. They have some orderlies always there to protect that doctor. But if the doctor is being hit, the doctor doesn't take a revenge. They don't take it against that patient. They know it's not their fault. Same way with these. I'm not saying they have become psychiatric patients, but believe me, they are in that level. Customers are in that level. They need sympathy. They need empathy. They need somebody to hug them. They need somebody to tell them to put their head on your shoulder and forget their worries. You are there to look after them. They are shouting. Let them shout. Let them take out steam. Put in the right words. Say you agree. Don't promise anything to them. Empathize. If you are a hotel property and the guests say, I could not sleep last night and I have an appointment, I have to give an interview, your bed was very hard. Don't argue with the guest and why you didn't tell us last night, why didn't you inform us. Maybe there was some reason, maybe he was feeling sleepy, maybe he said okay tomorrow I'll do it, but it was too much uncomfortable for him. At least he's telling you now. So don't make them more angry. Don't argue. Tell them, apologize. Tell them, sorry, sir, we didn't know that. Or sorry, madam. We will do everything we can before you come back from your interview. And by the way, all the best for your interview. You are going to succeed. You are a winner. And then take action. Change that bed. Change that mattress before the guest comes. And to really pacify the guest, when you have changed the mattress, you have changed everything, put a bouquet of flowers on his bed. Or after 8 chocolate box on his pillow with compliments of the management. Do you think this guest is going to go away from your hotel without remembering you? Imagine that guest coming back and he is angry. He knows that he will catch you. He's planning. You have really, really not been fair with the guest. He wants to fight. He wants to come back. He wants to find the same bed, same mattress, and he wants to shout at you. But when he enters the room, first of all, he looks at the reception. You are not there. He asks the other people, I had complained about the mattress. Yes, sir, it has been done. Okay. He goes anticipating that the mattress will still not be to his liking. And he will have another shouting match with you. So when he enters, he sees that card, compliments of the management, he sees that chocolate box or a cookies box or a fruit basket and some bouquet of flowers on his bed. And he sits on the bed and the bed is medium to hard. It's not very soft also, then he will have another complaint. And he is really surprised, pleasantly surprised. He starts smiling. And he salutes you in his imagination that I salute you. You have taken the fight out of me. I was looking forward to a fight, but you are the victor. Thank you.